Hi, this is Munson from Munson Music, and we're going to talk about an easy way that you can strum through Can't Do It Without You from the Austin Allen Show. And it starts off with this cool little lick where you can play first fret on the A string, second fret on the A string, and then third fret on the A string. So we're going B flat, B, C, and we're going to end up capoing this on 6th fret, just in case you're warning. B flat, B, C. So you may want to kind of work that out. Intro idea kind of comes back for that kind of intro verse, and the chord that would back up that lick would be a C major chord. When we play C major, first finger goes to the B string on the first fret, second finger on the D string, second fret, and third finger on the A string on the third fret. And if you strum the A string to the high E string, that sounds a C major chord, and it sounds really, really happy. And our intro, you could just kind of vamp on that C, and you could use just downs if you wanted to. Or a lot of times with a song like this too, I like to use something called a strum pattern. And one of my favorite strum patterns for a 4-4 like this is down, down, up, up, down, up. So you could use that too and just have the C with the down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up. And then from there, then we hit our main pre-chorus. And we kind of start out on the C major chord. But then we go to a G major chord. Play G major. First finger goes to A on the second fret, second finger on the low E string on the third fret, and third finger on the high E string on the third fret. And if you strum all those together, that sounds a G major chord, and it sounds really, really happy. And on that G chord, though, you will kind of hear where the A string on the second fret B note's kind of coming out of that. That's called a G slash B if you use just the A string and the high E string. And then from the G or the G slash B, we go to an A minor chord, and we play A minor. First finger goes to the B on the first fret, second finger on the D string, second fret, and third finger on the G string, second fret. And if you strum all those together, that sounds an A minor chord, and it sounds really, really sad. And then from the A minor, we go to an F major chord. We'll talk about an easy way to play this, but normally you do it as a bar on the first fret, second finger on the G string, second fret, third finger on the A string, third fret, and the pinky on the D string, third fret. And if you strum all those together, that sounds an F major chord, and it sounds really, really happy. I could substitute for that, though. It can be something called an F major 7, where you do the first finger on the B string first fret, second finger on the G string second fret, and third finger on the D string third fret. And if you strum the D string to the high E string, that sounds an F major 7, and it sounds really groovy happy. And then we go back to our C major chord, and then our G slash B, and then we go to an E minor chord. First finger goes to the A on the second fret, and second finger goes to the D string on the second fret. And if you strum all those together, that sounds an E minor chord, and it sounds really, really sad. And then from the E minor, we go back to our F, and then we kind of almost do a stop time F where you may want to do a big down on it. So through that whole pre-chorus, you got kind of that C, G slash B, A minor. Then we go into our chorus part, and our chorus starts on the C, and then we go to F, and then we go to A minor, and then we go to a G major. We do that 3 times, and the last time you heard this cool little hit where you do the C and the F and then the A minor, and then it almost sounds like we kind of half a C major with a G major at the end. And one way to do that is you could take the C and do the down down of the strum pattern, and then hit the G with the up up down. Last time through, you'd have the C, F, A minor, C down, 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 up, up, down, kind of digging on that lick. And then we'll basically be repeating those parts through the song. Now, the weird part is, instead of starting on a C major chord, in the tune, we're actually starting on a F sharp major chord, or F sharp major key. So you want to take a capo, and if you put it on the 6th fret, then now your C is really an F sharp major chord, and your G is really a C sharp major chord, and your A minor is really a D sharp minor chord, and the F is really a B major chord, and the E minor is really an A sharp minor. But to take it from the very beginning, you may want to kind of kick it off with kind of that intro lick, just that 1-2-3 idea. So that might be kind of a cool way to kind of work it through that. Intro, or that, you could just kind of start it out with kind of that C with the muting, or you could do the down, down, up, up, down to kind of just fill that time. And then once we do that C eight times or the lick four times, then we hit our main pre-chorus. And then we got our C, G slash B, A minor, F, C, G slash B, A minor, F, and up again. And then from there, then we go into our chorus part. So now we're C. That I like to add to a song like this is bass notes, and a lot of times on that first down of the down, down, up, up, down, up, you can throw in a bass for the chord. So on the C, you'd have the A for the bass, on the G, you'd have low E for the bass, unless you really want to bring out that G slash B, in which case you do the A string for your bass. On the A minor, you'd have the A for the bass, on the F bar, you'd have low E for the bass, and on the F major 7, you'd have the D for the bass, and on the E minor, you'd have the low E for the bass. Try that next verse with kind of just a bass down, up, down around the C chord too. So you might want to think of maybe using that too, especially if you're just kind of struggling through it or kind of digging on that. And then once we do that eight times, or the lick four times, then we go back into our pre-chorus part. So we tried that with basses. We'd have C with an A bass, G slash B with an A bass, A bar with an A bass, F with a bass, down, up, down, C with an A bass, G slash B with an A bass. That we'd be going into our next chorus. We had basses to the chorus. You'd have C with an A bass, F with a bass, down, 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 A bass, G with a low E bass, C, F, A minor, G. Or if you know there are licks around these chords too, you know, it can be kind of cool to kind of mix it up a little bit with some things. Last time we got that half. Bridge is kind of all a big vamp on the C. You just want to kind of stay on the C with the downs, or the bass down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up. Or if you know other licks around that C chord, you can kind of throw them in. And then after that bridge, then we go into kind of our last chorus. So we have C. That's the basics of how you can strum through Can't Do It Without You from the Austin and Ally Show. So good luck!